All right, ladies and gentlemen, Travis Keller with Penn Live, and I'm here in Lititz, Pennsylvania with a group of young ladies who did a red balloon prank that got a lot more attention than they bargained for. So Peyton, in the center, you're the ringleader of this prank, is that correct?
Yes.
So walk me through, how did you come up with this idea?
Okay, well, so the new Stephen King movie, it is coming out on Friday. And we had all, like, seen the trailer and watched it, and, like, we all knew about, like, the red balloon, and that's what, like, the clowns lure the kids into the sewers with. So we kind of, like, used that, and then also they did, like, I saw this, like, a while ago, I can't actually honestly forgot about it, but, like, I saw it again recently. They put, like, as, like, the movie theaters, like, put a red balloon to a sewer, but they, like, spray painted under it and said, like, it is closer than you think, and it was, like, a paid, like, promotion thing that they did, but, like, it wasn't, like, too big, and then I was like, we should bring this to America. And so I was like, we're going to do this tonight, guys. And then...
So who was the victim of this prank? Who initially was the victim?
Well, initially it was like just our like peers, like our classmates. Like we put them at places that we knew our friends would see them. Like we just started with like small developments that we knew a bunch of our friends lived at. Like we put a balloon in front of her house to freak her out. And then... when we like were done with the developments, we decided that we wanted to like do all over Lititz. So then we went to like main parts of Lititz that we knew like people would see them. Like,
so literally, you and your friend just started putting these balloons everywhere. You really didn't have one victim in mind. You just wanted to start putting these balloons
out because of
the scary movie coming out.
Yes.
So when did you do this?
We did this on Monday night because it was, we just started school today, and so it was like our big summer like end like blowout. And we were like, let's just go out with a bang. And we just expected it to be like a small little thing. And
so you expected it to be a small little thing. Was it a small little thing?
No, not at all.
So tell me about what happened. You started doing this on Monday. Walk me through what happened next.
Okay, so basically I was like, guys, we have to go to Giant and do this. And they're like, what are we going to do? And I was like, we got to get red balloons and sack, like tie them to sewers. And so then,
you can tell your part.
Okay. All right, where I took the part?
Yeah. Okay, so we stuffed all the, 24 balloons?
Yeah.
Into my trunk, and we put some of them held them in the backseat. And then we started driving around, because we were like, okay, well, now it's time to spook Lititz, because we were like, all finished spooking our friends, and like, we didn't really get any feedback from our friends, so I guess we wanted to spook Lititz, so we did.
So, you just started putting random balloons all over Lititz while the scary movie's coming out.
Yeah.
So had you guys heard any reaction from people within the town? What have you heard from people doing this? Anything like that?
A lot of people put it on their Snapchat stories if they would like go past one or something like that. And a lot of people have been talking about it at school. And obviously it's like in the news, so they know about it that way too.
Sure. So obviously the police got involved.
Yeah.
Walk me through how that happened. How did that play out?
Well, were you able to this? How the police responded?
Like, what do you mean?
Well, they
saw the balloon, obviously, like, in Lititz, like, it was close to the police department. They, like, posted that thing on Facebook, and we were kind of, like, scared, I guess, because, like, it's the police. They were kind of, like, joking about it. They just said not to do it again.
And that like started to get a bunch of shares and like likes, and then it was like going crazy. And so then the cops like they started to get in on it, and they posted later. They like posted a thing saying we're like sending the balloons off for investigation, like fingerprints and stuff. And we thought they were being like serious. And then we scrolled down, and it was a cop dressed as a clown. So we knew they were like joking. But like when we first saw it, we were like, uh-oh, we're in big trouble. But
so it was basically a prank on a prank at that point.
Yeah, basically the cops were like they were so cool about it and stuff. And, like we were DMing them and. They were fine with it.
So you guys haven't been in any trouble for doing this sort of thing?
Well, we're having a funny follow-up. Like, our parents are talking to them tomorrow. We're supposed to, like, meet up with them and stuff. And we feel like they're probably going to, like, say something like,
that's don't not, do that.
Yeah.
But you guys haven't been in, like, any formal trouble or anything like that?
No, luckily.
So this all started on Monday, right?
Mm-hmm.
So here we are on Wednesday. It sounds like this has gone viral to some extent. What's it like looking back on this and seeing your prank that was supposed to be to scare little Lititz, Pennsylvania, turn into something so much bigger?
Well, I mean, initially, we didn't even think anyone was going to know what it meant. We thought maybe people were just going to, like,
Like, oh, look, there's a balloon by the road, but, like, that would be, like, the extent of it. But waking up the next morning and seeing, first of all, we were also surprised that even the police, like, posted something about it. But then even hours later, we were seeing that there were videos with, like, thousands of views. And it was just so shocking. Like, none of us realized the extent of how far it was going to go.
Do you think you guys succeeded in scaring anybody?
Yeah, we like spend like the morning and like the whole day just like reading people's comments, and they're like, oh no, like her brother even like sold outside of, okay, we like put, let me tell you.
So we were driving past like Rossville Fire Company, and we put one outside, right outside that, and my brother like lives near there, so he looked out the window and he saw us, but he didn't know it was us. I don't know how he didn't recognize my car. And he put it on a Snapchat story, a picture of the balloon, because he thought the clowns were coming back from last year. And he was like, oh, hell no. And then he saw that I saw his Snapchat, and he called me, and I was pretending we were sleeping, because we didn't want anyone to know that we were doing this. And he was like, do you see my Snapchat story? And I was like, yeah, what's that mean? I'm scared, I'm about to cry. And he was like freaking out, and he was scared to walk to his car in the morning to go.
Everybody was like frightened and stuff, but like when we were like putting the balloons out, we were like blaring music, just driving through town. Like we could like hop out of the car, tie them, and like she'd like zoom off, and we'd hop in, make sure nobody would see. And like when we would like tie them to the sewers, we would like slowly like we'd all turn around and like watch the balloons as we drove away, and like they were just like dangling. It was like so creepy. Like
we scared ourselves.
Yeah, like, we honestly, yeah, it was spooky. Like, even stick like when. Like, me and Jenny tied a lot of them, mm-hmm. and when we, like, it was so scary, like, sticking our hand into the drain, like, every time I went down, like, I was so, like, scared, because that's just so freaky.
All right, so obviously, you know, you alluded to the fact, you know, the clown sightings last year. Did that ever cross your mind? Like, did that ever sway you guys, or was this just harmless fun?
It was harmless fun.
I never heard of the clown thing before, until people were like, oh, like, they're doing this because of that.
Sure. So, you know, in hindsight, would you guys, you know, let's time travel back to Sunday or whenever you thought of this idea. Would you do it again?
Yes. Yeah. Like, it was just, like, your mom, like, her reaction to it
was so funny.
Say what your mom was like.
So, I actually wasn't home that night, and when I woke up the next morning and I came home, I guess they tied one to the grate right in front of my house where my brother parked. So, my brother untied it, and he parked where he needed to. And he went in and told my mom about it, and my mom loves this movie. So she was like, oh my gosh, she called me. She was like, there's red balloons everywhere. I drove past Peyton Street. There was a red balloon on her street. Like, it's everywhere, all over Mitts. She was freaking out. Like, we went to the nail salon. She told the nail people. They had no idea what she was, like, talking about. They had no idea what this movie was. She was telling, like, everybody in the nail salon, like, there's red balloons everywhere. Like, what kind of creep would do that? And then I had no idea it was them either. And I was just scrolling through Instagram, and I see Jenny posted a picture of them in Giant with all these balloons. And I was like, you're kidding me. Like, it was fantastic. Like, I thought it was some creep or, like, some, like, one of the clown things happening again.
So... You know, obviously, you guys are kind of paying ode to a, you know, a great film. Are you guys planning to go to see the new one?
Yeah. She actually works at the movie theater, and yeah, she was going to bring me to see, like, the premiere thing, but we can't go, so we're probably going to go together, like, because this is, we're going to remember this forever. Like, it'd be fun to just go and see the movie that we, like, brought so much attention to.
Had you guys seen the original?
No, sadly.
I have.
So,
yeah, she has. Like.
So this is really about as random as it gets in terms of red balloons.
It honestly, like, it just, it was such a... I don't even know. It was just a
horrible prank.
Yeah, it was just a spontaneous, like, let's do this, let's freak some people out, and then...
It worked.
It was,
So, the first day of school was today, right?
Yep. Yeah.
What was that like, dealing with the first day of school, and then obviously your rise to internet fame? What was that like today?
Well, like, people in her class, like, you can say what...
Oh, yeah, in my civics and government class, we were each supposed to write, like, different things that are going on in the news today, and a bunch of my classmates were talking about, like, oh, like... Did you hear about this balloon thing that's going on? And I was like, maybe. Like, oh, yeah, I heard all about that.
All right. Does anybody have anything else you'd like to add about this experience? Anything I might have missed? Anything I didn't ask?
The
cafe.
Yeah.
The cafe thing. Did you
want to
say it?
No, I wasn't there.
Jenny, go. Oh. Oh, yeah. The next day before it was really, like, that big of a thing, it had just gone on Facebook.
What day would that have been?
Tuesday.
Okay.
So yesterday. Oh, yesterday. We were in the cafe.
in Mannheim, and I turned around, and this lady was on her laptop scrolling through Facebook, and she actually scrolled onto the Lititz post, like the police post of the red balloon thing. So I kind of like turned to HB and Peyton, and I was like, should we say something to them? And I turned around, and I was like, not to like eavesdrop or anything, but I see what you're looking at, and that was us. And they're like, no way, no way. So I showed them the pictures of us tying the balloons, and they thought it was so funny.
So it sounds like it was a well-received prank all around.
Yeah, it's, and the cops were contacting Peyton to like the follow-up, and they were saying how a bunch of people who are gonna dress up like clowns and go to the park on Friday, and they like said bring a red balloon.
Yeah,
like,
it's like
it started like a clown
festival.
Like so, so because of your prank, there's gonna be a clown festival.
I'm pretty sure it's because of our thing. Like the cops, it was so funny. I was just sitting at lunch and like, I was like talking to the police officers and stuff, and then like I just randomly got a thing. It was like the Lititz police sent me something. I'm like, what did they send me? And I opened it. And it's like an actual like invitation thing, but like it's like I think it's just like everyone in Lititz just can go and just like clown or dressing up, and like it says bring a red balloon, and it's at 6 o'clock.
It's
at the Lititz park. Be there.
The movie comes out.
So
all right.
We took a picture of, so we put 37 balloons around Lititz, and we like, we're planning to like, do like, a slideshow, because we took a picture of every single spot we put a balloon at, and like, we haven't put that out yet, but we're probably gonna put that out soon.
So 37, was there any significance behind that number, or was that just what you guys got to?
It's just what we got to.
We could fit in the car.
Yeah.
We kind of wish
we did 27, because like, the movie is coming out 27 years later. Like, that's the whole significance of it, because every 27 years, like, the clown comes back, like, it. And so, that's why it's coming out tomorrow on Friday.
All right. Anything else anybody would like to add?
How about why you decided to show your faces? So
oh, yeah.
Yeah, why decide to come forward with something like this?
We didn't want, like, kind of, like, we didn't want people to be scared, like, think that there was actually something bad that was going to happen. And also, we didn't want, like, someone else to, like, pretend that they did.
Yeah, we wanted to take credit for it, obviously, because it was, like, going crazy.
Yeah. Well, mostly, we didn't want people
so
to, like, feel
scared.
Right.
Sure.
Yeah.
It's honestly crazy, though, because, like, the one video that CBS posted, it has, like, over 2 million views. Like 100,000 is hard to, like, wrap your head around, but, like, thinking that 2 million people saw that is just bizarre. Like,
it's so surreal.
Like, we'll just look at this, like, all this media about it, and we're like, oh my gosh, that's crazy. And then we're like, wait, we did that. Like, every picture you see of that balloon, we tied, we connected that, like, we did that. And it's just crazy to think, like,
we stayed up really late for that.
Oh, yeah, you just, you never really
spent 3 hours of tying balloons.
The cops just told me that, like, around the world people were sending, like, them things about this, and I was like, I guess it takes $30 to make the world go crazy. Like,
all right. Anything else? Anybody else like that?
That's it. Yeah.
We had fun doing
this. Yeah.
Yeah. It obviously paid off.
It was fun hearing about it, too.
Yeah, I'm glad.
It was really funny to find out it was
your funny when, like, people were getting scared that we knew, not, like, other people, because I would feel bad if it was other people, but, like, our friends were getting, like, freaked out from it, because we, like, they didn't know, and we're like,
sure.
We did that.
It's also it was kind of funny because, like, when we were reading the comments, there'd be, like, people that were like, oh my gosh, like, not all heroes wear capes, like, about us doing this. And then some people were like, wow, I hate people. Like, there was, like, a lot of, like, hate and love about it. So,
wow, I hate teenage girls more now.
Yeah, well, yeah, just rude comments, but
definitely something I'm going to remember for the rest of my